Spring is probably my favorite time of the year in the Scandinavian nature. Here in the northern part of Denmark where I live, I'm close to both the coast and the forest. And while the ocean almost looks the same, the forest changes so much. Not only in color, but it's like everything just comes to life. It's like a new beginning, the circle of life. It is now summer, and I'm so grateful for all the awesome moments I've already had this year. I've spent a lot of time in nature with my camera and with my friends. And I've also got a new terrace, finally. My life is much more than just nature photography. And for a while I've been thinking about how I could share a bit more of that with you. I don't know how it turns out, but now I'm trying with this little story. This video is brought to you by Squarespace. If you want a professional looking website, head over to squarespace.com/Morten Hilmer. Hey!
No. Hvor mange flammer der er i?
Det er godt, Theodor. Der bliver lavet noget brænde.
I am in the forest together with my very good friend Frederik and his family. And we have made a little camp here in the forest.
Hi, Frederik.
Hi, Morten.
And basically, the plan is just to spend the day and evening here, sleep here in the tent and in a tarp for tomorrow, get our breakfast and then head home just to be out a little in nature here when it's most beautiful in the spring. And maybe you can see behind me the sun is about to set. It's about 9 o'clock now, so we have a little late dinner. We have all been teamworking to get, we have cut down some dead trees so we have some firewood. And Frida has made some salad out of plants from nature. Of course, not poisoning plants, but good plants. Bjørn is probably the only one who has not helped with anything here. He has just been faffing around, begging Frida for treats. But I think that's it for now. Now we're just going to have a cozy evening, have something to eat, have a beer, relax, and then, yeah.
Thank you. viser det.
Yeah, let's close it. All my bees had died this winter, and I don't know why, but my good friend Frank, he's a beekeeper, he has saved me again this year. He gives me some good advices, and now he's coming with a complete new bee family, and hopefully I'll be more lucky this year, because I really miss my bees, and without any of these families, there is no honey and no little bees faffing around in the flowers.
Yes, and this is pollen, and this is for the, it's a protein for the larvae.
Perfect.
Load size.
Oh, Frank just says it looks really good. There are a lot of food for the bees they have collected, and there are drones coming out, so in a short time this family will explode in size. That's completely the opposite of my other bee family. So it's awesome.
You can taste it if you want to.
Here, where can I just press?
Yeah,
just press. First fresh hunting this year. Hopefully not the last. So good. So, are they fine there? Yeah. So, let's cross the fingers for this little new family. Whoop. Frank, I'm a little curious, because the reason why I got the bees in the first place was two things. The honey, because I love honey, and I would like to make my own honey.
Yeah.
And the second, because I have all these trees and flowers, and I've heard a lot about the bees are really good for like the biodiversity, and I don't know the English word, but for the flowers.
Yes.
But what
else pollinate can they pollinate the flowers, and you have berries and something like and so on to help other birds and other game in the area. So they do a lot of for the diversity and help other species in the area.
Oh yeah.
So, if you think about what we eat, about 70% of what we eat have been pollinated by bees.
Yeah.
Wild and honeybees.
Oh, so they really play a massive role in the bee. But are there any threats to the bees?
There's a lot of threats. All the bees are under a lot of pressure. And it's due to multiple reasons. One of the main reasons is that we don't have that much nature. It's especially in Denmark, we have a lot of agriculture, and there's nothing in large areas. If you have large fields and no fair hedges anymore.
Yeah.
So there's a lack of places where they can live. That's one of the main reasons, and they are under pressure of, I think, some of the chemicals that we use in our society.
Oh, awesome. Now I just crossed my fingers and so yeah, we need some more bees around. That's my conclusion.
Yes, and you have a lot of, there's a lot for the bees you have. Well, there'll be a lot of honey in this area.
I'll definitely share with you when I eat my first honey thing. But thanks, Frank, for helping with the bees. And yeah, let's hope the bees are getting healthy and good. And I'll definitely show you some more clips, hopefully for the next week or so, when they start to really fly in and out. It'll be awesome to have bees summing around here again. Buzzing, not summing. Anyway. Bees are in the house and hopefully they will grow to a big healthy family and we can get some honey and some nice bee flying around here on the farm. So yeah. So this really, really makes me happy. Finally, after a year without the bees, this beautiful sound of, I don't know if it's called buzzing, is back. Oh, and these bees are so friendly. Like, look. I love this sound. It's like life is back in the garden. But yeah, let's give them some peace so they can build up the family, bring honey in, and just have a cozy time in this little community. Oh, I really love bees. Now it's time to get a cold beer on the terrace. And yeah, bye bye, little bees. Very soon, the berries down there in the forest will be, no, not very soon, but in a few months, I can pick my berries down there and make my own jam, and that is really good. But oh, mm.
Hello.
Hello.
What are you doing?
I'm painting. On El Casa.
It's going to be really, really nice to see what Simon is doing. Hello again, Simon.
Hello.
What are you doing?
Yeah, we're trying to make all this wood ready for the new terrace.
Done. An hour and a half, hopefully, we're done with the wood. And then on Saturday, we're going to put up the little balcony, or what it's called, the one that's standing up. And then another few weeks and the terrace should be fine. So, yeah.
Yeah, there he comes.
Yeah, two beer.
Oh.
Det trænger vi til.
Ja.
Min den er lidt stærkere.
Oh, I've been dreaming about this for a few years now, and now finally let's go out here and have a look. I just need to finish the edges now, and then yeah, I'm going to put some stones around and maybe some, I don't know, flowers, something to make it look a little cozy. But tonight I'm going to sit there with a cold beer. Can't wait. Look at this guy, he's not helping at all. It's now a few weeks since the terrace was finally finished, and look at this, it's so nice. Simon is here, we are working a little bit, having a beer. Let me just get out here so you can have a look from outside. Hello, Simon.
Hello.
And from the leftover wood from this building project, we made a table without any screws or metal or anything, just old-fashioned way.
Oh, Smeagol. Hey, Misen. Hey. How are you doing?
So, There's just one thing I want to share with you, something I'm really, really happy about, and that is the fact that I'm getting a new website within a week. And it's not just that I'm getting a new website, it's that, like, it's the first time I have not made my own website. And I can't tell you, like, how good it is for me, because I don't have the time to make it, I don't have the time to maintain it, I don't have the time to make the layout and just make it work. And so, for the first time, I have someone to make it for me. And it's not just someone, it's actually a very good friend of mine who has a company. He's making web design, he's making, he's a filmmaker, he's just graphic design, like, he is extremely creative and just very, very good at what he does. And he offered me to make my new website, and just said to me, like, you know, you just take everything you do and, like, the stories, the photos, your style, and I'll take it as a challenge to take that and put it into a website that just show who you are and what you do and what your heart is beating for. So it has been amazing, it has taken a lot of time, but it's amazing, and now I just can't wait to show you that website. And now, where we're actually speaking about websites, this video is sponsored by Squarespace. But even if it wasn't sponsored by Squarespace, if someone, some of you, came to me and asked and said, hey Morten, I'm going to make myself a website, I want it to look professional, I don't want to spend all that time maintaining the site, I just want to make something where I can share my photos, maybe even sell some photos, some prints, a calendar, or some online products, I want to make it, like, I just don't want to spend my time on designing a website, I want to spend it photographing and make my products, and it just has to work and look awesome, I would recommend Squarespace anytime, of the same reason as I just said. And the thing that's so good about Squarespace is the fact that it's all under one hood. It's not like a bunch of plugins, it's not things that get, like, it's not compatible with each other. You basically just choose a theme, put your own photos in there, change the text, change the layout, and then you can build a page within 1 hour. And if you really want to make it awesome, you just spend some more time, spend a few days making, and then you can really customize it so it's completely unique. So yeah, if you want to get a new website or update the one you already have, head over to squarespace.com/Morten Hilmer to start your free trial and get 10% off your first purchase. I will leave a link in description. But now, look at that awesome fire Simon has started. So yeah, this is really cozy. This is actually what I've been dreaming about when we were building this place, this terrace. It's really awesome. But yeah, let's have a sip of beer with Simon here. Cheers, Simon.
Cheers.
Oh, awesome. So yeah, what's going to happen now? I'm going to share another little nice moment with you when I was in the forest together with my good friends, Simon, Jens, Anders from Elsmer Island. And yeah, we just had a cozy evening in the forest. And yeah, it's a little different video, this one. Just thought I wanted to share it with you, a little of my daily life, because I do more than just photography. Like, my life is not only behind a camera, I also actually have a few friends and a daily life, and I thought, why not share that with you in this little kind of vlog, you can call it. But now I'm looking forward to going on the little island, you know, with the badgers, go out with Susie the scientist. I'm looking forward to spending a few weeks in Switzerland photographing there. I'm going out with Simon, hopefully to put holy cow! Woo! Anyway, I'm going to put a little more effort into making time lapses together with Simon. So we are probably doing a summer road trip with sliders and stuff like that. And yeah, just let's see what the summer will bring. And I can't wait to share all of that with you. So yeah, take care and see you out there.
Don't wanna sleep tonight at all. Just wanna watch them stars fall with you. Who don't wanna try to make up dreams just to be seen. it's not what